Hey, what's up, guys? DiplexHeated here again. Welcome back to Men of War Assault Squad 2, and welcome back to the German Super Fortress. In the previous video, the Brits tried to assault the fortress and enter it, but unfortunately for them, the German defenses were too much. In this video, we have done a few changes to the fort itself, and today the Soviets will be assaulting in a similar manner. 600 British soldiers attacked with 54 tanks and a few static weapons. They were all stopped. Today, roughly 700 Russians will be attacking with a few fewer tanks, so to speak. The waves have just been redesigned a little bit. The Russians are, however, attacking with heavier tanks towards the end. So, it might not be very like them to do quality over quantity, but in this scenario, they're going to be attacking with less tanks, more infantry, because in the end, infantry is what's going to win this battle. As you can tell, the defenses have been reorganized here on the fort. They did take a lot of losses in the previous video, so they've had to change a few things around. The PAK-43 has been replaced with a 210mm Mörser gun. It says Mörser in-game, but I think that's just because they don't have the Sweden has that letter, so I believe it is the Mörser. And of course, we have two Nebelwerfers on both sides. There's two of them. The pack bunker still remains, the MGs are still active, and instead of the flat guns that took so much fire in the previous video, and that would be the 20mm AA flat guns, we've replaced them with some 20mm naval guns, which I think it'll be quite cool. Also, the green giant, or whatever you want to call it, the main gun, the crown jewel of the fortress, has been replaced with a twin gun, 120mm coastal cannon, as you can see there at the bottom. So we're going to take a little bit of a better look at the defenses. So yes, this is the 120mm twin gun. It's an artillery piece. It's not meant for direct fire. Just like the other gun, it will sort of shell the positions instead in an arc. We also have the 88mm submarine gun here, the Flak 41. So a lot of naval guns on the fort today. You can kind of say it's received a naval upgrade or the naval edition. Yeah, this is the naval edition, minus the Nebelwerfers and some of the Flaks back here. But we don't have too many naval guns at our disposal. Here's the Flak, the Nebelwerfer 41, the 150mm one. I could have employed the Nebelwerfer 42, which is, I think, the 230 or 40mm rockets. But I think this will make it more interesting. The mortar still remains. A lot of the MGs at the front have been replaced with the 20mm MK-10, which is pretty cool, I presume, the Mark 10. And then we have more up here, it's the same gun, judging by the name, but it's in a different look. So instead of having a quad gun, two quad guns here, since they were destroyed, they've been replaced by some twin cannons with singular operators. So that's going to be cool. It's a bit of a naval edition. And here's the 210mm Mörser 18. And just before we start the battle, I do want to make sure that I was right. Yes, it is the Mörser, not the Mörser. It says Mörser in game, but that's just because they don't have the right letters for it. And the pack bunker is still very much active. I don't think yes. The Brits did manage to destroy packs, but packs are easily replaceable, so they've brought up more packs here. So we'll see if this defense is something that the Russians can take down, and we'll see if it has if it works in the Germans' favor or if it works in their disadvantage, so to speak. First Russian wave, without further ado, is going to be Marines. So it's a little bit differently. The Marines are obviously more skilled fighters than the regulars, but in this case, we're going to throw lighter tanks and heavier infantry at the defenses first, and then we're going to kind of step into the more regulars and more regular tanks. But towards the end, the Russians will be bringing in a lot of heavy armor. Unlike the Brits, who only really had one final wave with the Churchills, they were not enough to really get into the fort, obviously. The Russians might have a better luck today with the heavier tanks. So I'm excited. Let's click start, and let's get this battle on the way. Yes, quiet. Whatever he said. Storm Zadania. Так точно, командир, товарищ. Товарищ командир. And the Russians are going like, Диплекс, что? Here we go. That's a lot of loud engines. Yep. And also the defenses here have been changed for better gameplay. The barbed wire wouldn't go down, so it was like impossible to break through. Oh, Jesus Christ. I'm waiting for the Mörser to fire. I really want to catch it. I think it's going to save itself for the second wave. Jesus Christ. Damages to the German defenses, pretty much non-existent so far, but that was a... Jesus Christ, those guns are heavy. They feel a lot heavier than the 20mm flags. And they've got the shields and the big-ass sights and everything. They're awesome. Yeah, this Mörser didn't fire yet, but this wave has been completely annihilated. A few Russians remain hiding here by the bodies, but it's time to bring in the next wave. And so we've got a lot of Russians back here. Soviets. This one's going to be very similar to the first wave. This is still a tier 1 attack. So in the British assault, we had 3 tier 1 attacks. We only have 2 tier 1 attacks in this case, so there's going to be more medium stuff later back, which will obviously work in the favor here of the Russians. And I don't even know what's up with my RS right now, but there we go. That ZSU-37 has got a mean engine. It sounds just like the T-70. Way powerful for a very light vehicle. It sounds like a bloody V8. Which I bet it is. Oh, the Mörser just fired, and it was a... Was that a Mörser? No, that was a pack. I figured it was a bit of a quick impact and a very small explosion. Oh, the naval guns are firing. Double salvos hitting back there. Nice. Come on, Mörser. Go for it. We know you want to. It's going to. It's just waiting for the direct... It's got a 210mm shell that it's going to place at the right point at the right time. It's not going to waste its guts on pointless Russian assets. And there aren't really any pointless assets here on the field today, but there are definitely a few priority targets compared to all the infantry. Oh, jeez. Look at them being slaughtered there in the distance. I can't hear myself. I must be extremely loud. Sorry. There we go. Come on, Mörser. Unleash the wrath. You can do it. We know you've got the guts for it. Just aim it and shoot it. Come on, guys. What are you? The Russians aren't going to be waiting for you. They're going to run up and take it over. So look at that. Okay, let me do it for you. Just target that position back up there. Just shoot. Yes, at the infantry. That's fine. We have plenty of shells in the back. Oh, don't change your mind. It's capable of firing. I've seen it do so before. I just think it's trying to make up its mind. Okay. Okay, Mörser. I mean, yeah, you're capable of doing it all. A few vehicles were repaired on the German side. Probably that means a few guns that needed repairing for whatever reason. Look at that, Russian infantry. Oh, jeez. And the Nebelwerfers are working efficiently here. But we've pretty much completely destroyed our own defenses. And that would be the last tier 1 attack. The Russians are going to step it up now with a lot more infantry and some heavier tanks. Not heavy tanks yet, but these might make a little dent in the German defenses. Okay, and the Russians are immediately aware of the chaos that lies ahead of them. Plenty of Russian infantry back here that I'll more or less have to allow get into the fight themselves. There's too many to control at once, but you can send up a few squads that will get the job done. Well, not the job done, but it'll attract more of the reinforcements further back. There's some blood down here. Look at that naval gun. I love that. Double salvos, and so far it's been active. I'm right now on wave 3 behind the Mörser, as previously, just waiting for it to kick into action. Oh, that guy got shot in the head. to shoot at something that really matters, that the defense would benefit from destroying, so to speak. Will this be the case? Will this be the shot? I think all the targets that it wants to destroy is being already targeted by other AT guns. There we go, yes! Oh, look at that massive explosion back there. We didn't have to wait too long for it. Jeez. I think it's time to send in wave 4 immediately, which is going to be involving some howitzers in terms of the SU-122. Давай. Here we go, and some more T-34-85s and some more Mod 1943s. I seem to have lost track of the Mod 1944 in the game. I can't seem to find it, so they'll have to do right now. Once again, there's barely any armored targets, mainly just static weapons and the German defense that's not going to need too much heavy armor to break down. But look at this. This defense is so far proving to be an upgrade. Hardly any casualties, or perhaps the Russian or Soviet attack is a downgrade compared to the British one. I don't know. They're not really making it as close as the Brits did. Shouldn't be the armor, although British armor was very qualitative. At least Russian armor took a little while towards the later bits of the war to kick in, but and so did British, to be honest, too. But I'm... Jesus, look at that. And the Mörser haven't even fired twice yet. There's just endless smoke pillars back there. It's interesting to look at the defense, or the battle from the defenses, because you get an idea of the destruction on the Russian side. Is the Mörser going to target the SU-122 back there? No, it's already knocked out, so why would it? Or isn't it? I think it's still active. The Mörser just needs to make... Oh, they're jumping out now, but we're taking fire over here now. It found a target it liked and fired, which was very nice. And right now, this crew is so overly privileged that they're having a hard time picking the actual target. Russian infantry advancing down the center. Okay, whoa! Two guns almost knocked out. At least the crew was. That's a progress or a step in the right direction. Infantry moving up. There, Mörser just fired again. Oh, boom, that was a big explosion. Units on the side being absolutely obliterated. This attack is not working as well as the British did by now. Could be the defenses. All right, Jerry, you have a few spare men that can... Oh, no, these have been knocked out. They have officially been destroyed, and I don't think there's any repairing to be done. Do they have a repair kit in them? Obviously not. So we've lost two of the guns up there. We'll just have to face that fact. How's it looking down here? These guns are still active? Even this one's still active. How are you doing on the... Oh, wow, the range is not so great. But it looks cool when it shoots. It really does. Mortars back here still obviously active. Nebelwerfers are reloading. That's the downside of having these side defenses. They're devastating once it hits the targets, but they take a very long time reloading. So does this guy. Very long time. Okay, well, I think it's time for the fifth Russian wave. And... these two waves are going to be hard. Lots of KVs, especially the KV-2s with the 152mm self-propelled artillery gun on top of it. It's going to be nasty for the German defense, but the infantry is plentiful in these waves. So there's a lot to go around for the German defenses, so to speak. But we'll find out what happens. I'm going to send up the assets in orderly fashion. Try not bring too much infantry up, because once they get... in squads, they tend to be less effective. So we'll allow them to be their own will. Mörser just fired again. It's getting into the swing of things. Now it's realizing the full potential that the gun beholds. And but one effective shell from the 122mm gun back here in an SU-122 will demolish the Mörser. But look at the flak fire. Just the bloody... This is crazy. Fences are starting to take some fire now. But the static weapons have longer range than most of the tanks, it seems. Nebel Reaper's firing again. Oh, jeez. Yeah, I think the naval edition of this fortress is quite an upgrade. The rear Nebelwerfers are demolishing the attacks, not to mention the Mörser, and the twin 120mm gun here is way more effective than the single 203mm gun. And these flaks seem to be harder to hit. And since they can target, what's good about having several flaks is that we have four here instead of two. Although the two would have, you know, more firepower at one target. Since these are single entities, these guns can aim at different targets. So the Germans can engage more enemies with these guns than the single flaks could, which is very nice to know. The flak 38s and the infantry is just being demolished. What do you do? Look at that. You turn into, I mean, you're... The Russian attack is multiplied by five every time it attacks, because every single soldier is turned into five smaller ones with blood coming out of them. Look at this. This Commissar is like, yes. Problematic. I'm gonna look the other direction. Would we be shot at if we retreat? He's like, let me see if Stalin's order is still in effect. Well, there we go. He's looking into the dirt. Cool. Let's bring on the next wave. And I think that in the next wave we'll do both at the same time. Just a crazy thing like that, you know. And this time I think, since there's so much fire going on, all I need to do is click free, and they will all run out to aid their fellow comrades. There's around 120 Russians, I think, in this wave, or 60. I can't remember exactly, but there's a lot. And 660 Russians in total, plus tank crew, who's more or less combat inefficient against the kind of defenses that we see here today. So, not, but around 700 in manpower at least, a little more. No static weapons. We knew that the static weapons did pretty good for the Brits when they attacked. But then again, they had one wave out of the eight that was just complete infantry. And the tanks are using the other tanks as cover, which is nice. If you can get off a few shots, you can actually destroy some of the defenses. Oh god. Look, we had a hit back here, but I don't think anything was destroyed. And all the flaks are still combat operational. This is gruesome. This is... Oh man, I thought the Russians would do better. More manpower, heavier tanks. The German defenses brought down to a few weaker guns. Nebelwerfers instead of flaks. But man. How do you explain this? How do you explain this to Stalin? This is what Fegelein built for Hitler. Look at that, it fired again. Impact is just massive, that even the tanks around the impact just explode from the sheer pressure. Look at that, engine just completely blown out. Wow, you rarely see tanks destroyed to that extent. Okay guys, it's time for the final wave. And for the Russians' sake, seeing as they have a little bit of an ability that I like to call like mass wave or whatever you want to call it. I just made that up, but you know, the Russians, Soviets, some people decline this rumor, but they, you know, in terms of throwing assets at the enemy, overwhelming assets, this might be the deal. Let's see how it works out in this scenario. There is just a lot of things going on in this wave. 10 tanks. KV-1s, KV-2s, and even IS-2s, at least one. And they're already firing. One accidentally hit a piece of the Russian remains. But I think this final wave will be important to watch from the German perspective, because a lot of things are going to happen to their defenses once the tanks get in range of the guns. Once the guns get in range of the tanks, in this case. I feel like a big deal, or a big... It would be very good for the Russian infantry if the 20mm guns up front could be disabled. And so far, there's still quite a few active. But we'll see what happens. Flak's still firing. That Mörser is going to open up very soon. I'm going to crew that gun there for a second. So much infantry swarming at the enemy right now. Mörser almost took a hit. Oh, jeez. German body parts. Oh, no. The Mercer's been hit. Isn't it out? I think the Mörser has been disabled, yeah. So, combat repairs. Go, go, go. Oh, jeez. Oh, jeez. Oh, jeez. Oh, jeez. The Russian heavy tanks are going to be doing nasty things to the German defense. How's this naval cannon holding up? Still active. Sandbags are starting to be brought down. Look at that. The 20 mils are now disabled. They're even blown out of the fort itself. And the infantry's kicking in now. MG42s and Gewehr 43s and even Panzerfausts are brought up to try and stop the advancing. Oh, that the Mercer's still active though. Jeez. Explosions everywhere. I think I'm gonna keep this setup for the American attack. Pack Fortress still active. Nebelwerfers, are they out of ammunition, perhaps? Nope, they're just reloading. There's like unlimited ammunition in this fortress. And honestly, I'm a little disappointed at the Russians for not doing better. And maybe that's my fault. I designed the attack. But I just... Come on. The amount of heavy tanks that they have at their disposal now. And just... Come on, punch through. KV-2, storm the attack. Or storm the defenses. It's got to be the German upgrades. Because this attack is hardly any... Jesus Christ, look at that. This attack is hardly any weaker than any other attack. If you just aim at that pack bunker, I promise you, you will reach very good results. And if you don't have a tank laying on you, there you go. Just shoot at the pack bunker. Boom. And look at that. What a little decisive decisions can do. And the Mercer hit to a point where this thing cannot be repaired. This thing is just gone. Cool. That was the work of one IS-2 and one KV-2, who is now longer not in combat. And the remains of the Russian attack, it has been... Well, you can see the remains, but it's, you can't talk to it. You can't control it, because it's body parts and equipment, and men getting shot down as they try and run at the fort in some crazy endeavor to gain some... metal, made of some metal in the Soviet Union. Pack bunker taken out. One pack's just been blown out of the bunker, but it's gonna work perfectly fine. Some of the MGs have been killed inside the bunker. You can see even some blood in there, which is very cool. But in general, very repairable, and the twin 120 mils still very much active down here. These beasts. Is it not? Hello. I think we've lost some crewmen. I'm wrong. Something's actually happened to the gun. It's got an engine that you can turn off and on. Maybe it needs repairing of some sort. Yes, it does. It's not really functional. But both Nebelwerfers are active, and all the flaks in the center are very okay. Some have taken... damage to the mount. But that is about it. Mortar here, though, completely killed. So in the American attack, I know exactly what I need to do. I think I need to replace this position with some snipers. Although this gun is still active, we might just move it down here instead, where the previous MG was. We'll have to reevaluate the German defenses, but we'll keep the Nebelwerfers, we'll keep the Flak, and the Mörser. I think I'd like to keep it. Write in the comment section if you want to see another type of weapon here in this main platform, or if you'd like the Germans to keep their Mörser. I've seen more efficient guns here. I definitely think the Pack 43 did more damage. But these guns, I'm in love with them. I think the US should be facing these as well. And not to mention, this gun here is still active and it should still be allowed to remain active. But yes, very excited to see the US attack. The Russian one has definitely been stopped. And I hope you guys enjoy this video, and I will see you guys soon again. Bye.